In the previous episode, we've started an invoice management system that is going to be built on PHP 8.1. We've created some sort of Hello World application. This application has one PHP class, one entry point that is index.php, and it uses afterloading mechanism provided by Composer Package Manager. So let's go ahead and continue this implementation. And in this tutorial, I would like to implement together with you routing system that will help us handle different pages for this invoice management system. This project includes a link to GitHub repository where you can download latest source code. And in the README file, I created a paragraph called branches, as well as series of videos or links you can refer to when working with this repository. So the idea behind branches is the following. We have two types of branches. First one is main branch. In main branch, we're going to have the latest code of this application. The second type of branch is basically an episode related branches, and each episode or each tutorial will have two branches: beginning of the code changes and after we implemented as part of the video tutorial these changes. So you will see E1, for example, for episode 1 start branch, that if we will switch, we will see basically beginning of the source code, and E1 end is end of the episode 1 source code implementation. You can check out, for example, this is episode 2, E2 start. You can check out this branch and follow along this video, or if you would like to get the ready to go source code after this video, you can check out E2 end branch and see what are the changes we've implemented in this tutorial. So in my PHP Storm editor, I use E2 start branch in order to start this episode. We have app.php, it's application class, and this class is used in the index.php file. And with the help of method run, we trigger our application and it renders invoice management system. So let's go inside run, and we would like to create a routing system. And in order to do this, I will go ahead and create a class, PHP class called router. This router will be responsible for dispatching a request. Let's go back to our system. I will create a new instance of a router. So as of now, we don't use any dependency injection. It means that whether I will be creating dependencies within PHP classes inside these classes, or I will be passing it through construct method. Later, we're going to refactor this implementation to use dependency injection, and all these dependencies will move to construct method and to the independent configuration file that will be used by service manager class and will create new objects or instances of dependencies that needs to be passed, for example, into app class. For now, I'm going to create a new instance of a router, and this router will trigger dispatch. I would also create a request object, and for request object, let's go ahead and create a new PHP class called request. This request class will provide me some information related to incoming request, and based on this information, like path, URI, or query, server related information, we will give this information to router, and router will decide how and what to render, whether it's a callback that needs to be executed or a PHP class that needs to be triggered in order to render particular content based on URI or URL. So this request will have to have struct method. We're going to have private array server, and this server variable of a class will serve our global server underscore server variable that we're going to use. I will need to create public method getServer, so we will have access to server related information, and let's call it mixed for checking whether we have a key based on this name. And let's create two methods. First method is going to be called getUri, and this is going to be a string. And in this method, we will use parseURL PHP function that will help us to get request URI from the server. Let's use our public method and let's return request URI and parse it through parseURL function. And second one, I would like to have a pass, and this pass can be used from the getURI method, and we're going to return a pass. GetURI return type should be array. Okay, so this is a request class. Let's go ahead to our application and let's create a new instance of request. So request invoice and pass this to dispatch. Here we expect request. And from the request, let's return request get pass. Let's do var dump pass. Based on the pass, we will find out what page to render. So let's check in a browser. Pass is forward slash. It means that we can render a home page. Let's say we would like to have invoices page. It will be invoices pass. And settings. Settings. It's going to be settings. So let me go ahead and create a routes array that will have mapping between a pass and a callback function. This callback function is a temporary because part of this video we're going to create a routing system, and in the upcoming video we will create action controller that will allow us to handle a request by a separate PHP class. It's called action controller. So for the homepage, for the forward slash is going to be homepage. Let's find out whether we have if array key exists, and we're going to use pass, and we will be using routes as our array. If so, it's going to be called a handler, and we're going to return routes pass. Or let's rewrite it, let's make it simpler and have it like this. And let's return this route. Return mixed. Mixed is not a good name, but we will change it. So let's go back to our application. We have handler as a result of a router dispatch method call. And let's call this handler like this. So let's go to browser and see what we have. We have settings. So our routing, it's simple basic routing that we've implemented. Invoices, it works, and homepage works. What will happen if we will type some random string and we have a fatal error? So in order to fix it, let's go ahead and add an if condition. We will check if we have handler so we can process this situation. And ideally it should be a 404 page that will be shown in case we don't have any pages or there is no match. This can be, this 404 page can be added to a router as part of a routing mechanism. However, it's going to be our next tutorial that we are going to work with. As of now, we implemented a simple routing that accepts a single HTTP method. It's a GET method. We will get back to this router when we will need more functionality like POST, HTTP request support, like adding 404 pages, and obviously we will implement action controller support or handler support for this router, so we will be able to create independent pages in our own PHP classes, so we can add these controllers and we can implement template engines that will be used by these controllers. All the changes we've implemented in this episode are going to be uploaded into a separate branch called E2End. So make sure to check out, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye.